with our first speaker for this year's Prost Mining Camp. We are joined by Dan Jabur from the Volksbank. And Dan is a process improvement professional who has working with processes and process improvement in the banking sector for more than 11 years, also with Prost Mining already for many years. And we are very happy to have him here and share his experiences with us today. Welcome, Dan.
Hi, Anne. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. So yes, let's not wait on anything, but please get started with your presentation and we can talk some more about it afterwards. The floor
Thanks.
Is yours.
Yes. Hi all and welcome at this talk about why it takes two to get value out of your process data. Hopefully you're sitting comfortably in front of your tent, and during this talk I will share my experience of how process mining analysts and domain experts complement each other. But first, something about myself. Over here, you see me at the summit in Zolder in Austria, at which I have a clear view on the different mountain peaks and ski slopes. And during this talk, I want to take you with me on a project mining case of an exploration to the summit of your research, where you have a clear view on your studied object, and especially why it takes two who complement each other to reach this summit. And during my experience as a business improvement consultant at the Volksbank, I had a lot of different projects where I combined different kind of roles, and I want to share it with you. But to help you to be prepared for your exploration to the summit, I will share my experience on three topics. I will share my experience about which kind of research to choose. Do you choose confirmation or exploration? And why does it take two? And the value of collaboration in dialogues between process mining analysts and subject matter experts. And which dialogues you have during a voyage of exploration. Based on the case of an exploration which I got value out of a process data in cooperation with an SME. But first, I want to give you a brief overview of the company I work for. The Volksbank has a promise that is better for each other. By banking with a human touch, we create value for customers, society, employees, and shareholders. As the fourth bank in the Netherlands with more than 3 million private customers, we realize high customer satisfaction with four brands, with SNS, ASN, Regiobank, and België Wonen. We have three main activities in terms of services: mortgages, savings, and payments. And within the Volksbank, we think three kinds of applications of process mining to contribute in the realization of our strategy. Process optimization, at which we create insights during process optimization projects based on Lean Six Sigma. Bottlenecks, wastes, and variations are identified. And also fact-based insights of lead time, rework, and process paths, and also customer journeys. Furthermore, process compliance, where we check process compliance during internal control and audit projects. Giving an objective view on the process performance on the and its compliance with rules and legislations, and where with verifying of change effects, where we're monitoring changes and their effect-based results during and at the end of process change initiatives. Over here you see three examples of applications of process mining within the Volksbank. The first one is new mortgages. Over here you see the top five of non-happy flow steps. This gives our client insights in where to fix root causes to have the biggest improvement of his process. The second one is accounts payable, at which we identified five steps that deviate from the standard and needs further research to improve those. Because this could be a deviation which is not desired, or a new best practice, or a violation of internal rules. And the third one is lead management, at which the process of conversion leads to customers with a success ratio per process step. These three examples show the added value of process mining in different process improvement projects. And in every stage of the BPM cycle, process mining can give you a fact-based insight. Therefore, in our organization, multiple consultants are educated in process mining and equipped with DISCO. And of course, in addition, have other tools in our toolbox, like ETL tooling, statistical tooling, such as Minitab or SPSS, and process modeling tooling. And also we work with different methods, such as Lean and Six Sigma. Over here, you see that the questions you can answer with Process Mind per stage of the BPM cycle. Like, what process do we have? What are improvement opportunities? And what do we change? And also, is the change incorporated in the daily business? And is the performance also as expected? So every stage within that BPM cycle, you can use DISCO. And during the application of process mining, my experience is that you always need to be with two persons to have a sufficient research, a process mining analyst and a subject matter expert. Especially the dialogue of those two during exploration is important due to the choices you make along the way up to the summit. It could be one person who masters both, SME and analyst, but most times you need two persons or more to complete your voyage. The value is in the dialogue of sharing insights, the explanation from different perspectives, and understanding the research objective. The analyst who masters data, and the SME who knows his domain like the back of his hand. But which kind of research is applicable? Do we start with a set of data to explore or hypothesis test? A research of confirmation, or as Anna called in the keynote, a targeted analysis. It has a different approach than an exploration analysis. You use confirmation when you want to gather compelling evidence to confirm or reject an hypothesis, or you have an expectation and want a database confirmation or rejection, or just a quantified measurement to have insights in the performance of your process, such as, did we realize our KPIs last month, or does our process always follow the path from step 1 to 2, or is it bypassed? When your data is available and the hypothesis is clear, this kind of research doesn't take a lot of time. The value of exploration is when you want to discover and understand your process, which process paths are followed, and how is the performance per process step. You dig and dig deeper to understand the behavior of your process. An exploration can take a lot of time due to the unknown, and it's hard to define if you know enough to end your research. If you made your choice, stay with it. Don't make the mistake to go for exploration during your research if you choose for confirmation. Exploration takes much more time to deliver your research because behind every insight of your exploration, there are new insights to discover. This makes the exploration could be a never-ending voyage. And if you're out there to explore, don't make the mistake to just come back with a confirmation or rejection, because that don't fix the client's need. So choose wisely and stick to it. Depending on the type of research, the collaboration and role of the SME and analyst differ. In confirmation, the SME and analyst work almost independently for each other. The SME defines the world to confirm and hypothesis to test. The analyst answers the SME's questions based on the right data. This could be done by a less experienced analyst due to the stated hypothesis and its measurements. And the exploration, SMEs and analysts explore together, are both responsible for the outcome, and together they interpret the data and insights in a journey of exploration. Along their expedition, they prioritize and make choices for the next step to the summit. The results are less predictable compared to confirmation due to the dialogues the SME and analysts have and a decision to make along the way. It could differ per individual and the paths they take. I want to share my experience of a collaboration during an exploration case I did last year at the Volksbank. This exploration case of lead time non-performance and what can we learn from our data started with our director mortgages provisioning and internal audit who had a research motivation because during the first quarter of 2020, the mortgage provisioning lead time was above the stated limit. And in the same period, lockdowns were also announced due to COVID-19 pandemic. And their assumption was that those two events correlated. And they asked us, what can we do to prevent the recurrence of this problem? So we framed a research question What can we learn from the process data of 5 years mortgage provisioning of four brands and its lead time to prevent the cause of non-performance in the first quarter of 2020? With two sub-questions. To what extent are the lead time targets of mortgage provisioning achieved over time, and which key factors played a possible role in achieving and not achieving those targets? During this journey of exploration, I had the role of analyst, and my colleague Camille joined the expedition as an SME of the mortgage provisioning process. To reach the summit of our research, we had continuous dialogues of insight, explanation, and understanding. We distinguished five continuous key dialogues during our voyage, which I want to share with you. But first, to get to the summit, we use different gear. And this gear is our data sources, such as a mortgage provisioning system and the capacity management and HR systems, but also reports and interviews to gather our information, insights, and explanations. And we use tooling to understand the data of our sources to define the route to the top. In this case, we use Microsoft Excel, Disco, and we apply this output in Minitab and Tableau. The first type of dialogues we had as a Prospect Mining Analyst and SME is definitions. The Prospect Mining Analyst and SME mostly start from a different perspective. The first need to have the same definitions to have a correct start of the climb to the summit. In this case, my first question was, what do we want to know? And Camille's question was, what can we learn from our data? So you need to find each other and have the same definitions to start your exploration. And the next step was, what is the right scope? What's the start and end event of this process? And what's the process scope? And what does it produce? In this case, we want to know where in time did the process disperform correctly and outperformed last year's, and which drivers causes this behavior. And the scope we defined, like for mortgage requests received up till final mortgage offer sent. And also we discussed which customers and customer types should be in scope. Furthermore, we also defined which success criteria are important for this process. In this case, it's STP processing of mortgage requests, the first time right completeness, lead time, and of course, customer satisfaction. Furthermore, we also defined what's the right data. Camille, as an SME, wanted to use the KPIs as we also use in the annual reports. So we had to research which queries do they use for this annual reports and where do they get their data. And we also had to define which system can we use and which data definition can we reuse. And also, you have the discussion about open cases. Do you use only open cases or also closed cases? And what time period do they need to be closed? And is there differentiation we need to consider? So step by step, you have your definitions and you know more and more about the process to discover. The second type of continuous dialogues is dimensions, which period of time and which products are in an out scope and which part of the process is not. And you look at your filters, which filters do we use? And also if you more towards the top, you have some filters applied and you didn't know for sure which did we use and why. So in the collaboration between the Prospect Mining Analyst and the SME, you are tuning those filters to get the right insights. To have the right period and complete cases and only new mortgage requests in this case. And if you go further, you also want to know in which time frame do you look? Do we look per year or do we look for the 5 years for the complete research scope? And where does our research period start and end? And which level of detail do we want to use? Do we look at a day, a week, month, or year? So those dimensions are very important to have there the right dialogue between the product management analyst and the SME. Another dialogue between the analyst and SME is about correlation and causality. Which causal relations do we expect and know? And which correlation can we test? Which variables are relevant and how are they related to each other? Which assumptions do we have? In this case, the assumption of the effect of inflow quality on the lead time was very important. So what we did is we built a causal model of the variables that possibly influence the lead time. So step by step, we build up all causal diagram. Lead time as dependent variable and the effects of amount of inflow and inflow quality on the process efficiency and also process stability affected by policy, process, and IT changes, and also the processing capacity, which is based on the amount of FTEs available and their quality. So bit by bit, we investigated those variables and also answers the question, is the data available of those variables? And does it have the right data quality? And is there a correlation? How strong is the correlation between those variables? So we didn't only use process mining with DISCO, but also hypothesis testing and statistical analysis, in this case with Minitab. Also, the continuous dialogue about primary and secondary is important. What is our main topic? Is the primary variable or secondary? And do we need to differentiate or converge? Over here, you see two examples. And the first one is, do we need to converge? Do we need to look at every different brand we have within the Volksbank? And also, is seasonality applicable or not? You see that at the box plots over here. Because every time in your conversation you are investigating, is this something which is important or not? Is it due to my main topic? Is only cycle time important, or do we also look at different aspects? And are all different product types relevant or only a subset? So step by step, you discover more and more. And sometimes you need to go back on your path to the summit. And sometimes you are right and you go straight forward. Are we there yet? That's a fifth dialogue, and that's about the summit. Did we arrive at our destination? Is the additional insight needed for our client to take the next step? Or are we over there and we can end the journey? In our case, with our data insights and in-depth domain expertise, we addressed three moments in time with significant dis and outperformance in lead time. We addressed causes and reject assumptions for dis and outperformance. With those insights, we advised our client with some next steps. We searched the three moments with an in-depth quantitative root cause analysis. Organize a retrospective with the mortgage provisioning management team, where you learn as a team from three questions. Did we address this and outperformance in these three periods sufficient? Which interventions did we initiate to retain the outperformance and this performance? And did we complete all steps of the PDCA cycle during this period adequately? With those insights and answers and next steps, we encourage our client to pursue or avoid and keep learning about the process, its behavior, and continuously improve it. But could I climb it on my own the next time, and now I know the path to the summit? Maybe, but even when you know the path and master both roles, you don't have the value of the dialogue, since those dialogues make the exploration. Go with two and have these five continuous dialogues up to the summit. Don't go on your own, but find the right companion. I hope you gained insights in this talk to be prepared for your own journey. Thanks for your attention and keep pursuing the adventure of exploration.
Thanks so much, Dan. Thanks very much for sharing the journey that you and Camille had on this project. Everyone who's watching right now, you can add your questions to Dan in the general channel in the Slack, and we will pick them up here in the Q&A part after the talk. And in the meantime, I already make a start. I have a few questions that I'm curious about. So one thing, Dan, I'm curious about is, you explained how the interaction with the subject matter expert was in these different phases of the analysis. But I'm curious, before you even get started, at the very beginning, usually the subject matter expert, they are not a process mining expert, right? So they're an expert in their domain, but not... they may not know anything about process mining. So you have worked with different subject matter experts over the years. Have you developed some strategies? How do you explain process mining to others who you have to work with in this kind of interactive way, but who don't know anything about process mining yet? Do you have any tips for people how to explain process mining in this situation?
Of course, it's the first per person, but what we developed is an internal course of such 101 course on process mining and the introduction. So mostly we take some of those slides from those course and have a quick overview of how process mining works and what is in process mining for them. And with some examples of previous projects, it will help and gave them enough insights to get started. And along the way, they get more and more experienced, and they see the added value of process mining and what you can do with it.
Right. And who else was involved in that? So that's also a question coming from the community, and I'm curious about as well. You mentioned, of course, the interaction with Camille, but you also were talking about a client. So was that client be part of the interaction in some part? And are there other people who were you were communicating or interacting with in other at other times as well?
Yes, mostly the communication did Camille as an SME, and he knew who to attach to our research. But of course, the client was very important because he has a question we need to answer. And moreover, some people from the IT department and some reporting specialists who built the annual reports. We collaborate with them to get our data and to give the right insights. But also we did some interviews with people within the mortgages process about how is this process working, how do they, what's their experience. And you combine all those insights with your process mining insights to have a better view on what's happening over here.
Right. So that's interesting. So the subject matter expert is taking on the role of communicating with the client in this situation. Was he part of the same team, or was that also an external team for him, for Camille?
Also, another team within our organization. So
right.
Another team within the mortgage division.
Mm-hmm. Okay, great. Yes. And how often did you have actually these communication and interaction points with the client or Camille had on your behalf?
Mostly weekly. We did. We had a weekly a call with our client, and also we had during the weeks different appointments with other colleagues to get our input for the research.
Mm-hmm. Right. And the client, how much did they also influence and shape the path that you were on with Camille?
Of course, at the start of the of the research, they gave us the research objective, and also they stated a research question, but we changed a little bit that question, because if we investigated just as a confirmating analysis, then we all only could say if there the influence of the lockdowns did change the the lead time or not. And I forget. Is your question again, please?
Whether they influenced the question.
Oh yes, they only influenced the question in the beginning, but we changed the question to an exploration question. Yes. To also have the insights of 5 year applying of 5 year mortgages provisioning, and use Prospect Mining to give those in depth insights.
Yeah, exactly. That's a really interesting dimension. This exploration, where this if you have a very clear question, you can really focus on that. But yeah, it's a different mode, right? I think that became very clear in your presentation.
Yes, it's really a different mode, and you need to tune that with your client to have the right focus, and that your client also want to have those insights and need those insights.
Yeah. Exactly. An interesting question from the community is why didn't Camille do the analysis himself?
Why he didn't? Because he didn't have any experience of working with DISCO. Didn't have any. How do you say? A training on that. So we worked together, and we had those dialogues, which also helped to give the better insights to our client.
Yeah, yeah. So of course you already had all the knowledge how to do things, but do you think he could have learned it if?
I think he could have learned it, because it's a tool you can learn with some training and applying it, but. Doing it together will give you some other insights due to the dialogues, and helps you to get the right insights.
Right. Yep. Okay, I had one maybe a little bit more of a technical question, but one of the points that you mentioned is that you have to decide how to differentiate or converge. And I understood that you were talking about the different products, right? So like, do you look at all of the products as one process, or
yes.
Do you split them out and look at them separately as separate processes? So how do you actually make this decision whether to split them up or look at all the products together?
Within mortgages, you have different kind of mortgages and also different kind of processes within your mortgages division. And depending on the feature set of those mortgages products, but also the process that's done for those products, you have a look at what is primary or secondary for my research, and where do I want to have my focus on. So you make that choice along the way. With the SME's knowledge about the process, and is it very important for this research or not?
Right. Yeah. Okay. We have one more question from the community, from Carolyn. She's asking, what value benefit messages have you found to be the most effective when communicating with business units when selling your services capabilities? So essentially, when you're telling them what you do with Prospect Mining, do you have, what value benefit messages have you found to be most effective when communicating this?
A value message? Now, internally, we mostly show projects we did before, and also the slide with the three examples, which I, in the first two examples, identified a top five of improvements. That will help always in your communication to show them what are early benefits of applying those insights. And the strongest point of process mining is the visualization of your process, and to point directly where improvement is applicable.
Yes. Yeah, to really objectively show how the process looks like, right? And to be able
yes.
to point to it and this is where things are going slow or where we have this rework loop or anything like that. Right. Okay, so maybe a last question, thinking about the interaction that you have told us and took us with you and that you had. What was the biggest disagreement that you had with Camille on this journey and how did you resolve it?
I think, should we take a variable into account or not, and how much work does it take to get the right data of this variable or not? That was the biggest one, because from the perspective of Camille, we should take it into account because it's an important variable. Over here, this was the quality of the FTEs within this process, but we didn't have enough information to really use that as an applicable data source. So there we had the conclusions to don't take it in account because it's not reliable, the data we have, or we didn't have enough data.
Yeah, that's interesting. Yeah, so there you need so many different things to come together, right? The understanding of, the reliability of the data, but also maybe what is actually involved in getting the data ready. That's something that you can judge much more by your experience from preparing data for process mining. So maybe something seems easy for people. They say, well, we have the reports, it's all there already, but then you know, actually, well, it's not. It's not that easy.
It's not reliable, yes.
Yeah. Okay, great. Well, thanks a lot, Dan, for sharing your journey with us here today. So we will continue the discussion in the Slack. So just continue to add your questions in the general channel. Dan will also be there and can also reply directly and also later throughout the camp if you want to know more about his experience. We will go into a break now until 1:15, and then we will be back with Dan and Sudendo, and we will tackle the broader questions of process improvement and how you can set those projects up, what are best practices. So we continue the discussion in a slightly more broader sense in the Process Mining Cafe today, 1:15, right here where you're watching right now. So I'll see you then, and see you there in roughly half an hour. Bye bye.